November Toronto real estate market. Is the market activeness as cold as the weather? Has the supply and demand imbalance been solved? Hi, my name is Priscilla. I'm a real estate broker in the Greater Toronto area. Today, let's take a look at the newly available real estate market watch report from Toronto Real Estate Board. Like in all the past months, I'm going to use two charts. The big one is October's performance, and the smaller one is 1 month ahead in September. When we compare the big chart to the smaller one, we see months over months change. Together, we study five parameters. Under each one of them, you'll see a percentage. This is the year over year change for the observation period over same period of last year, 2020, October. Let's directly jump to the factor that everybody pays most attention, which is the average sold price. In October, across the whole Greater Toronto area, for all property types, the average sold price arrived at 1.155 million. So this is another 1.7% increase from September. The number was 1.136 million. So in last month's video, I already shared, I said this number, the 1.136, was already the historical high. After that number, we climbed another 1.7%. 1.7%, it's not a small number, because if every month over last month is 1.7% for the whole year, it's going to be around 20% increase, which is very remarkable. In fact, it is true, because if we look at 1.155 over October 2020, the average sold price was 968,000. It is 20% increase. I think a lot of people would agree with me, the increase is quite significant, right? It's in just a year, property price went up 20%. So what is the cause of that? Actually, I think it's carried on for quite some time now. I keep mentioning, I said that is due to the very severe imbalance of supply and demand. Let's take a look at the new listing. New listing is the number of properties enter into the market, become newly listed. The decrease trend is the same as last month. In September, the new listing number had a 34%, one-third decrease from same period last year. So we had 13,000 properties newly listed. The decrease carry on the same, also one-third decrease from same period last year, which was 17,800. But what's more serious is the total number of active listing. Active listing means all those available properties for sale. So this number is less than half comparing with October 2020. Last year, we had over 17,000. And in October, we had less than 8,000. It's only 7,750. Actually, this number, from my memory, is almost the lowest. I want to point it out how serious the supply is. So let's take a look at these two charts. The first one we are looking at is 2019 real estate stats. The green line is the active listing for each month, and the red line is the number of transaction. The active listing varies from some like 7,000-8,000 to 20,000. But mostly it's around 15,000. So let's say the year average is about 15,000 every month. And for sales, the number varies from 4,000 something to 10,000. So let's say average about 7,000-8,000. So a lot of the months or the average, we can see that the active listing is twice of the number of sales. At any point, you have 2 months inventory to choose from, for buyers to choose from. That is the market norm. The reason I choose 2019 is this is the one full year that's not impacted by COVID. So let's treat 2019 as example of a normal year when the market is relatively balanced. So now we remember this number and switch back to 2021. In 2021, we see two remarkable change from 2019. The first is the sales volume in a couple months is very, very high. Let's take a look at the March. March was a peak of this year. We reached the transaction number at 16,000. This is the peak for very, very long period of time, over a decade, to have such a high transaction volume. But more than that, it's the relationship between the number of sales and available properties for sale. for many months, we see those two lines, they are joined together, meaning that for any point from May to September, how many properties are available for sale in that month? How many properties are sold? And in some of the months, very exceptional months, actually it's February and March and October, which we just had, the number of sales is even more than the available properties for sale, which means it takes less than 1 month for the market to digest all its inventory if there's no listings joined to the market. So now you can sense how strong is the shortage of supply comparing with the demand. Okay, let's go back to this chart. So now we understand the dynamic between supply and demand. So now we are now surprised why the property is the property prices keeps going up. It's simply the buyer don't have enough to choose from. And another parameter to improve to prove this point is that if we look at the average days on sale, last month is only 14 days. Now this month, October, is only 13 days. It takes in average just less than 2 weeks for a property to be bought by any buyer. And this is quite a significant decrease. It's actually 23% decrease from last year's 17 days. 17 days is already a short number, right? I encourage all the buyers in a strong seller's market like this, get yourself prepared, get your pre-approval and everything before you enter into such a market. No need to browse properties before you are fully ready, because the properties you see is not going to sit there and wait. Remember, it only takes less than 2 weeks for any given property to be bought away by buyers. In terms of property types, you can see that basically detached kept going and semi-detached the same situation. What really caught my eyes is a freehold townhouse. Actually, double verified this number. Last month, the average sold price for City of Toronto 416 area is only 1.15 million. But for this month, it's 1.34. It's quite a significant jump. But the total number of sales is only slightly above 100. So I understand probably because it's a relatively smaller number of transactions. So a couple more expensive properties can impact the average price quite significantly. But despite that, I think we can all agree that the trend of freehold townhouse is going up quite rapidly. Actually, for October itself, it almost on par with the semi-detached. My understanding could be the freehold townhouse in City of Toronto is relatively new, and the semi-detached could be older properties. So even though the size of the two properties are not the same, but the age of the property make the price gap smaller and smaller. All right, another property type I want to join your attention is a condo apartment. Condo apartment is the property type that increased the least in the past 1 year or year and a half. So a lot of property type, because the low interest rate, because a lot of strong QE policy going on, the property price went up, but not condo apartment. I explained many times that this is due to many offices in downtown still work from home and some students are still not returned to downtown Toronto yet. But it resumed mildly bounced back starting from February this year. But the recovery is quite moderate. So last month, 744, it was an increase from October. But this month, we had another 5,000 decrease back down. My observation, looking at the number and my own experience when I take clients for showing when they try to shop for a condo apartment, is that the condo apartment market right now is a balanced market. This is very different from rest of the freehold properties, which in a lot of cases you see on offer review day, the seller can receive something like over a dozen offers. Condo apartment is not the same. A lot of times when I go for showing, out of five properties, there's only one for bidding. The rest four would just lease for what they want to sell. So again, I feel this is a good chance for those residents or investors. If you really want to get a condo property now, this is a good time because it is a relatively buyer-friendly market. You get the time to take your time to choose the property you really like, and you can even bargain a nice price. Okay, so this is the end of this video. If you have any recent purchase or sell plan, talk to me so I can cater the strategy for you. And if you're looking for properties, not only I can send you the ones that match your exact standard from MLS, but I will also include those great deal off-market properties. Looking forward to connecting with you soon. Bye-bye.